representation. What made you say it was boring? Artists and their patrons wanted to create idealized, picturesque images of what they thought art should be. I mean, come on, guys. This isn't what we want to make. Photography was developed in the year 1839. You can't even imagine the impact it had on the art world. Before, the reproduction of an image took forever. Now, anyone could have an exact portrait of their loved ones, their home, whatever. This, paired with new printmaking technology, snatched art away from the elite. Now, anyone could have any picture they pleased. Now, don't be frightened. Photography didn't make painting obscure, as many art lovers feared. Rightly so. You don't need an artist to get a picture of your mom. You can just use a camera. And you can be damn sure it'll be done in time for her birthday, and no one will make her look sour or fat. It's great, but oh no, what if you're an artist? Now there's a machine that makes paintings better than you do. Well, a handful of artists answered the call. They embraced photography as a means of redeveloping painting. Now, the canvas echoed the camera's viewfinder. Artists could use reference photos, and they didn't have to concern themselves with making exact copies. I mean, think about it. What is paint anyway? It's so gooey and colorful. Why try so hard to make it look like something other than what it is? What if the world were made of paint? Today's old master was one of those revolutionaries. He adopted many photographic techniques into his artwork, and in the process was on the forefront of modernity. His work is considered by many to be some of the first pieces of truly modern art. Today's artist is Edouard Manet! Manet lived and worked in Paris in a time when the elite judged what was or wasn't art. He himself came from a decent upper-class family. However, his idea of what art should be was drastically different from what was popular at the time. In order to be a successful artist, one's work had to be judged at the Salon. Manet's work wasn't only rejected, it was openly scorned by the public and ridiculed by the press. Today's painting was no exception. It was submitted to the Salon in the year 1866, and it was rejected outright. Today's old master painting is... The Spiker! I guess the world wasn't ready for this kind of controversy. It's sad and ironic the way this art stuff works. Oh well, are you guys ready to paint? Okay, now, to copy a painting is always ideal to be copying from the original. That isn't always exactly plausible. You see, a viper's in France! So, today, I will be copying from a photographic reproduction. You can get your own. You'll find it in any art history textbook, or Google Manet himself, even on the internet. Trust me, it's so easy! Let's begin!
Thank you.
blue, red, yellow, black. No one used black like Matt A did. And look at all this red. It's so sexy. Oh God, look what I did. Maybe I should have used a smock.